The number of infants born with syphilis in the U.S. has reached a 20-year high, according to the CDC. It's a number we're seeing reflected here at home in Fresno County. Here to talk about what's causing it and what it means for our community is infectious disease doctor Quentin Doporalski.
Now, we are seeing an increase in syphilis rates here in Fresno County. What can you tell us about these numbers?
Sure. So recently, the CDC has released some information about particularly neonatal or infant syphilis numbers. And in 2017, they had determined actually over 900 children in America were born with syphilis, which is extremely high number compared to what we've seen in years past. In addition, the prevalence or how common having syphilis is among the general population has continued to increase for the past 5 years across the country. So it certainly is something that they're very concerned about.
Why is it happening here?
Sure. So that's a very complicated question. And I think the biggest part of the answer to that is really a combination of things, one of which is lack of prenatal care or poor prenatal care. So we find overall that the mothers who've given birth to children who have syphilis tend to have a lot of socioeconomic struggles, poverty, addiction, things of that nature, that probably prevent them from obtaining all the prenatal care they need, or make that very difficult otherwise.
What is the risk of this disease to infants? Yeah.
So infants who are born with syphilis that they obtained from the mother, while they were in utero, they have several different problems that can occur. There can be things like mental or physical handicap. Even stillborn babies are a possibility as well.
And interesting to note too is that this is preventable. We can help these infants. What needs to happen?
Absolutely. So syphilis, I think it's important that people know, is extremely preventable and it's easily treatable. So obviously, in terms of prevention of syphilis, the best thing that one can do is to stay, any sexually active adult to stay in a monogamous relationship or have a good discussion with any partners you have about that issue. Now, in terms of treating syphilis, it's typically treated with a simple antibiotic, just penicillin, one of the oldest antibiotics we have available to us. And there are also alternatives for people who have a penicillin allergy. If caught early, typically needs to be treated with just one single dose of penicillin and it can be cured.
You mentioned having a conversation with your partner or partners.
Yes.
Because you can give it back to each other. Can you explain that?
That's right. So one of the difficult things we see with syphilis is that, it's a treatment, not a cure. So, if you develop syphilis, it can be treated with penicillin the very next time that you have any sort of sexual activity with that other partner. If they haven't also been treated, you can immediately be reinfected. And we see that quite frequently. So it's important that, any diagnosis or treatment of syphilis be done in the context of whoever you've been sexually active with.
Okay, good information, doctor. Thank you.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.